Hello and welcome back to the channel and welcome to a box. No, I'm not going to run the intro loop just yet. Welcome actually to my lunchtime. It is the middle of the day and I'm not going to do a beer review right now, but this box just landed from Seven Brothers and I've got a bit of an idea of what's in it, but I thought I'd share this with you and then we can hopefully review it straight after this. So let's take a look. I only nearly cut my fingers off. Beer. In here, the people at Seven Brothers are always just too kind. We have the new beer from the Seven series called Eureka, which looks, I'll be honest, very kind of somewhat Viking themed. Look at that. I do know a little bit about this beer already, and the reason it's Viking themed, I suspect, is because it uses Kveik yeast, which is Scandinavian in origin, so that makes sense. And there's not only one tin of it, but there is two, which is already too kind, so only need one for review. But they've also given me a third, which is very nice of them. So let's get this box out of the way. So there we have it, three cans of the new Seven Series beer. This is from Brother Keith. It's an IPA, 7%, but it's obviously a Kveik IPA, which is makes things a little bit different. I have seen a bit of content on this already, and I do know that whilst the predominant hop is safe, they did use Citra for some aromas. There is a dog tail just here. Hey, pup. So how will we get on with it? Well, I still think it'll be incredible. It just depends on how much hop has been used. So let's get these in the fridge. We'll cut to the normal intro and I'll join you in a minute, possibly in a different t-shirt, possibly not, depends on how long it takes me to do it, with a beer review. And just like that, it's the end of the day and it's time for a beer. I am still wearing the same shirt, surprisingly. But let's get back into this. My mind has been completely boggled by work and general life over the last 4 or 5 hours it was since the scene before, but nothing's changed really. So it's time to get into this. I was about to say it's called Keith, which just explains to me how tired I am. As I mentioned a minute ago, this is for Brother Keith. It's an IPA, but it's a Kveik IPA, so it should have some interesting fruity flavours, and it is called Eureka. Seven Brothers did release a clip about this beer, which they explained that Keith, Keith worked in Scandinavia for a while, and a lot of their beers are made with Kveik yeast, which is why this is kind of his inspired journey. So I know you saw it again a second ago, but just before we crack into it, here is another look at the can. Now, the bad news is that did smell a bit like Citra when I opened it, which is unsurprising given that it is used within it, but I was hoping not for it not to, if I'm honest, but here we are. Something there that resembles a half decent pour. In the glass then, you get that proper juicy Nipah vibe, nice foamy head, super hazy, I mean you can't see anything through that at all. Proper yellow, almost custard, but just a little bit too bright. On the aroma, now remember Kveik yeast has a fruity thing, but they also, I believe, dry hop this with Citra, which is giving it that extra kind of punch in the nasal department. Yeah, it's unmistakably Citra, but there are other elements to it, so I'm going to try and ignore it as much as possible. Very Nipah bag, it's very mango, passion fruit, maybe a bit pineapple. There's some pininess, some resinous to it as well. A bit of a tip to, I guess, West Coast styles. But this is just listed as an IPA. It's not meant to go particularly one way or another. I reckon it's going to be super juicy. But I think it is going to have a bitter edge as well. I'm not getting a whole much more from the aroma, if I'm honest. But it does smell excellent. And this is a standout in that department so far from Seven Brothers. Because a lot of their aromas tend to be quite subtle. This one is not. This is punching big time. Big juicy flavours. So let's get into it. Cheers. Thankfully, it's Citra on the nose, but it doesn't come through an awful lot on the palate, of which I am very grateful. It's not hugely bitter, but the just from that one sip, the outstanding kind of quality about this, well, is the quality, but also the balance. It's incredibly well balanced. It doesn't go too heavily one way or the other. It's not harsh and aggressive, but it's full-bodied and full of flavour. Super fruity, super tropical. And then a bit of hot burn at the back, along with some resinous kind of attributes. So let us do a top to bottom taste test. Initially, a touch sweet and a bit of mild carbonation on the front of the tongue. I think it's probably the best description. And then you get a tiny bit of bitterness, kind of the front middle of the tongue. You get a few hints at some juicy flavours, but they're subtle at that point. It's like a sweet lemon, some of the grapefruit, maybe a bit of pineapple acidity in there as well. That rounds out into something a bit more drying, not so bitter necessarily, but a bit of a drying sensation. The fruit actually washes out for that next phase. It becomes much more beer-centric, if that makes sense. There's a bit of malt, there's a bit of hop. It's just more like a traditional pale ale, not leaning too heavily one way or the other. And then you get a second wave as you swallow it in the aftertaste, which is fruity again, but much more earthy as well. That piney, resinous kind of bag. What's interesting about this is it doesn't have the traditional fruity splash lick that you get with a lot of beers. The second phase is quite fruit forward, and then the kind of aftertaste is quite fruit heavy. But then that middle bit where you'd normally expect a lot, you actually get just quite a clean drying sensation. What else is there to say about this? There's a bit of orange in there, sweet orange, citrus peel. It's reminding me of kind of a lot of Northern Monk's beers, but I'll be honest, slightly better than theirs. It's got that vibe, but it's a better rounded beer than most of their pails. I find a lot of theirs trying to go extreme in one direction or the other. This isn't. This is keeping it truly, truly in the kind of, I don't know, in the proper IPA, proper strength, proper taste, but also impeccably balanced ballpark, which is, it's probably something not all that many can achieve, really. It's got to be something quite difficult. Bit of stone fruit in there, subtly at the back. Peach, plum, nectarine. Again, it's really subtle. We're really kind of picking out very tiny cues here. But that, despite the citra element, is actually pretty fantastic. Let's take a look at the can. From the Seven Brothers 7 Series Eureka, 7% beer, 440ml can. As we said before, lovely Viking Scandinavian themed artwork on the front there with a load of hops and other bits making up that pattern. It says, we're 7 this year, which is a special one for us, so we've decided to launch a series of 7 beers, 7 brothers, 7 years, 7 beers, and 7 unique ideas, all at 7%, as every can in the 7 Series says. We need a 7 counter. We've said it a lot. This one is Brother Keith. It's an IPA. It's a 7%. Again, 440ml can. It says the allergens are malted barley, wheat, and that's it. It says, from Oslo with love, Keith's time in Oslo was the inspiration behind this Kveik style IPA. Skål! Skål, Keith. As all of the 7 Series cans, this is 3.08 UK units, given the size of the can and the 7% alcohol volume. And that is really all it says. So this is a very good IPA. Now, I am really struggling, the more and more I drink 7 Brothers beers, is to kind of rank them against each other. I have a few firm favourites, which are ultimately the sweeter, maltier styles, just because that's my kind of preference in beer. As soon as we get out of that into the wheat beers and into the IPAs, I'm struggling a bit more about where to rank them. This is much more a traditional IPA than a lot of the stuff they've done before that I've had. Now, I'm sure they do others, but almost everything I've had from them IPA-wise has been a bit of a different spin, a bit of a different take, some different flavours. I have one straight-up IPA from them, but it was much more of a traditional IPA bag, whereas this is, I say, more kind of American influence, I would say. But as far as this style IPA goes, and I'll be honest, this is a style that typically I don't gel with all that well, especially when they use Citra, which they have. For me to say that this is borderline excellent, it's pretty astounding, really. I mean, I think there'll be some people out there who absolutely adore this. There'll be some people out there who don't like this kind of flavour profile, as I often don't, who will still dislike it. But the one thing you can't take away from it is the fact that it's just an incredibly well put together and a quality beer. If you like your juicy and kind of bitter, quasi-bitter IPAs, Mountain Style is becoming ever popular. It kind of sits in that territory, not quite East Coast, not quite West Coast, but full of those flavours from both parts. This is an exceptional one. So that is really now everything I have to say about it. So as always, thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like it. If you haven't already, subscribe if you will be so kind, and I'll catch you next time. Skål.